Congratulations on becoming that leadership. What I study is what works and what doesn't in advice. In graduate school, I got interested in self-help. So I want to begin with the idea of what is self-help. There's this kind of stigma with self-help that only losers need advice. Folks who read self-help tend to be more successful, more educated, and more affluent than average. And when we think about the type of person who reads self-help, these are the achievers, the innovators, the thinkers. It is actually a much cooler club to be in than most people give it credit for. Why? Well, because if you value things like self-control, then you want more of it. If you have success in your career, you want more of it. Leadership self-help, business self-help, has to be non-fiction. It's advice for how to actually change your behavior, not just stuff about how to make yourself feel better. But one of the downsides of a lot of business self-help is that it focuses on the individual. And one of the great things about what we're going to be doing today is focusing on becoming a leader, not as an individual, me, but as a we, as a community, as a team. There are plenty of self-help books out there that make big promises but don't deliver. And the way they make those promises is by repeating them over and over and over again. You will be successful if you follow my advice. Did I mention it? You will be successful if you follow my advice. This is not the same as proof. But the way our minds work, when things get repeated over and over again, we tend to believe them. The extreme self-help is really kind of sinister because it takes academic research and kernels of very good ideas and then distorts it. The other end of the spectrum, there are all sorts of cute books, like Chicken Soup for the Entrepreneur's Soul. You know, it has some sweet quotes in it, but it's not going to really transform your life. It's sort of generic self-help tells a lot of stories of transformation. But spoiler alert, most of these stories are not true. They're called magnified moments, where I would take a little bit of your story, and then a little bit of your story, and I would put them together to make the perfect story of how successful someone would be if they followed my advice. There is lots of circular logic in some of these books, and worse yet, they are solipsistic, which, by the way, is one of my favorite words. I teach it to all of my students. Solipsism is being really self-absorbed and making everything about me, me, me. That's what doesn't work. But let's talk about what does work. Well, it's humility. It's knowing that we are all learners. We are all lifelong learners. The idea of growth mindset. Just because I'm not good at it now doesn't mean I can't be awesome at it later. We need to ask questions before we come to the answers. And ask questions about the people who are giving us advice as well. So the three questions that I think everybody needs to ask are: what matters most to me? Why does it matter? And then how can I make it happen? Ask whether it is closed, meaning it's my way or my way, or open, meaning ask questions, customize it to who you are and what you believe. And if you can customize it, and you can make it your own, and you can embrace purpose-based commitments to change, you are very much on the path to becoming a great leader. As Warren Buffett said, in a time of drastic change, it is the learners who inherit the future. You are the learners. You are doing this right now. You are opening yourselves up to the best of leadership and business advice. And my hope is that with these practices that we talked about today, you can continue this journey, have even more good advice come your way.